Hi, I'm Paul. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. Now that we've taken a look at different market structures, let's take a deeper look on how firms profit under different types of market structure regimes. In a competitive economy, the supply curve usually slopes upwards. Firms have to choose what production costs in order to include when they determine how much output to eventually produce. The two big concepts here are marginal costs and total average costs. Let's go over each of them individually. Marginal cost is a cost borne by the supplier to make one additional unit of product. And conceptually, the marginal cost curve can look like a J. This curve describes a scenario where in the beginning, to make something, a firm produces it at some unit, but as they make additional units, it might become cheaper, where Q goes to Q prime. Since this is an environment of perfect competition, however, a single firm does not benefit from economies of scale. So it might mean that it takes additional costs to make additional units of product, and that's why the curve slopes like a J. It becomes more expensive over time to make additional units of product. From the perspective of a formula, marginal cost is the change in cost over the change in quantity. Now, let's add the average total cost curve to the marginal cost. As the name suggests, the average total cost curve takes into account all the units produced and not just each one like the marginal cost does. Its formula is the total cost divided by quantity. The average total cost can differ than the marginal cost given fixed costs or efficiencies in production. The average total cost curve can look more like a U instead of a J, since in the beginning of production, there is a fixed cost spread over a small quantity that eventually gets spread out as more and more quantity gets produced. The average total cost can decline over time since more of the overall cost is spread over more additional units. However, as the marginal cost eventually inflects upwards, so does the average total cost. Let's take a look at a more concrete example to illustrate this idea. Let's say a perfectly competitive firm produces one unit at $10 after investing $20 in capital. Now, the marginal cost of that unit is $10, but the average total cost is the marginal cost, $10, plus the fixed cost over one unit. So the average total cost curve is $30. Thus, the marginal cost can be different than the average total cost, especially very early on in the production cycle. Now that we're taking a look at what drives the supply curve aside from overall demand, we can start to find out more about how firms maximize profits at a given quantity and a given price. If you want to learn more about additional topics, please consider visiting us at Chegg, where you can see additional topic videos and even speak to one of our subject matter experts. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you at Chegg.